What's good, man? You back with your boy, Billionaire Charlie, man. And we got a good one today, y'all, man. Got a lot of great information for y'all, man. Y'all don't forget, man, to go down to the links below, man, to sign up for the programs if you're trying to make some extra money. And remember, I got my Amazon store at the bottom, too. You know what I'm saying? Y'all can shop and get all the great and amazing things y'all are looking for. But today, man, we got a crazy one today, man. A real, real crazy one, man. Oh, man. And I want to thank everybody that support the channel, man. Everybody that go hit that like button and hit that subscribe button and share the videos, man. We're growing each and every day, man. We have 16,000 followers now. You know what I'm saying? So appreciate the love. Appreciate the support out there. Well, let's get into it, man. Delonte West, man. Man, I seen that video, man. It hurt my heart, man. You know what I'm saying? That was despicable, man. To watch that man get beat down in the street like that. And everybody just recording it and nobody stopping it. You know what I'm saying? It was rumored that he had like mental illnesses and things of that nature and supposed to have been abusing drugs and things of that nature. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of people still remember the quotes and things that he was saying about his relationship with LeBron James' mother or whatever. You know what I'm saying? It was rumored that Delonte West was smashing her and messing with her or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And it just went viral all through the NBA at that time. I remember during the playoffs, LeBron was playing bad as hell. It was like something was on his conscience. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of people believe Delonte West got kicked out of the NBA because of LeBron James. You know what I'm saying? Because the face of the NBA is LeBron James. And a lot of people was feeling that LeBron had something to do with the fall of Delonte West. You know what I'm saying? And everybody remember when that year when the summer came or whatever, LeBron decided to go to Miami. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people felt that it was that distrust with the teammates. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of people felt that LeBron felt some type of way about how Delonte West did what he did or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So. And then, like I said, Delonte West made quotes on saying that he was messing with LeBron's mama. And then all of a sudden, he took those things back and said that was false. They were saying he was like bipolar and stuff like that. Now, me, in my opinion, I don't know the individual personally, but I would think that if you make a person image to be bipolar or stuff like that, he's unbelievable. You know what I'm saying? So if he actually was messing with LeBron's mom or whatever, you know what I'm saying? You ain't gonna believe that was true because they saying he's bipolar, schizophrenic, all that type of thing, putting the mental illness thing on him. You know what I'm saying? So the things that he's saying, people ain't gonna be feeling like it's valid, basically what I'm trying to say. So I don't know if that was created by the media or LeBron team or was this real factual. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But like I always say, man, when you see something like this, just think about it, man. You got a person that worked their whole life to get to the NBA, making millions of dollars to play the game that they love to play, and then have some unfortunate like this to happen where they end up, you know what I mean, strung out and dealing with mental illness, you know what I'm saying, and losing everything. You know what I'm saying? They talking about a fall from grace. This is a fall from grace for real. You know what I'm saying? When you making millions of dollars, you playing on the playoff teams, and you having great success in your career, and then to fall and be embarrassed and humiliated on TV, getting beat up, mollywopped right in the middle of the street, man. And he looked like he homeless. You know what I'm saying? I remember that when I seen that Steve Francis thing, man. I was like, these guys, they had them like using, you know what I'm saying, drugs and things of that nature, man. I always say, man, drugs is a curse upon our culture, man, because so many people that we grew up with had parents and stuff of that nature that fall victim to those circumstances. You know what I'm saying? Like, my dad was using drugs and things of that nature, man. And our bond ain't coming till later on in life. You know what I'm saying? I didn't even get a chance to really get a chance to know who he was as a person because he was always gone. He was always running the streets. He was always trying to chase that neck high. So I didn't ever could build a relationship with him. You know what I'm saying? But later on in life, you know what I'm saying, God willing, he allow us to build a relationship. But like I say, when you talking drugs and you talking mental illness, those are some really wicked things that come upon people. You know what I'm saying? So when I look at this Delonte West and Steve Francis, people that I seen that was like all-stars, you know what I'm saying? Steve Francis was an all-star, you know what I'm saying? A very, very great and amazing player. He was on 2K Live, one of them, you know what I'm saying? He was a beast, man. You know what I'm saying? For his size, you know what I'm saying? We talk about Allen Iverson, but Steve Francis was that guy, you know what I'm saying, in Houston. You know what I'm saying? So just watching it, man, it's got to be heartbreaking, man. You know what I'm saying? To see Delonte West to go through all of this stuff, man. And he's still at a young age, though. That's the crazy thing. He's still at a young age. He should still be in the NBA, living a successful life. You know what I'm saying? But like I say, when you're dealing with drugs and mental illness and things of that nature like that, that can ruin your whole entire career. They could just suck the life out you. And then you see him. Because think about it, they've been had a video of Delonte West, like, on the streets and stuff like that. And they were saying he was kind of off the rockers on those things. But like I say, is it the media creating that because of what they were saying before about he was making comments saying that he was with LeBron mom or whatever. You know what I'm saying? People don't really know if it's real or fake because he came back on his statement. Now, we don't know if it was pressure behind the scenes to, you know what I mean, tell people that this ain't how it's going to go. You know what I'm saying? Because like I say, man, you got to think about it. What was the other guy? Because LeBron played with another guy that was messing with his mom. I think it was like, was it Ray Lewis or somebody? Not Ray Lewis, Rashad Lewis or something like that, that was playing with Ray Allen with the Sonics or whatever. He ended up coming to Miami for that year. I think they won that year, too, with Ray Allen. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, like, this the thing I've been saying. Is just, like, sometimes some certain situations can be distasteful. And I just feel like LeBron felt a real tight way about that. I know I would have felt a type of way about that. And then I think being that Delonte West was saying stuff in the media, I feel like that was even more disrespectful. I feel like he felt like he was just out of pocket or whatever. Maybe. Now, like I say, they nobody ever got the actual LeBron story. But, like, to see the fall of Delonte West, because Delonte West was a good player, dog. He was a good role player, man. He was a scrappy player, man, that played hard. So to see him not in the NBA and homeless and all on the street like this, it's ridiculous, man. You know what I'm saying? Because the man got talent. You know what I'm saying? Unless he got some talent, man. You know what I'm saying? I was just looking at that, man. I'm like, nah. But I had been seeing pictures like that and pictures of Steve Francis and stuff like that. Because I think Steve Francis, they took his chain off his neck in Houston. I think Jay Prince had to get it back for him. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I just feel like when you were in the NBA and you around all these women and stuff like that, you partying and stuff like that, and then people get to using these different drugs and stuff like that. See, sometimes you got to be able to say no. Don't allow peer pressure to put you in a situation where you end up having an addiction that you have to live with for the rest of your life. You know what I'm saying? I know growing up in the neighborhoods, everybody's smoking weed or doing this and doing that. You know what I'm saying? You get influenced to try it. Let's see what it is. You know what I'm saying? But some shit, you try some shit that you ain't going to be able to say stop or be able to walk away from that shit. It's going to be a whole process because the shit is so addictive. You know what I'm saying? And I just feel like a lot of people fall victim of that. You know what I'm saying? Think about it. Lamar Odom. Hold on. Let me say, I think I'm saying his name right. Lamar Odom with the Kardashian, right? He was smoking crack. You know what I'm saying? Like smoking crack and just living a reckless lifestyle. He ended up being hospitalized. You know what I'm saying? Couldn't even move or do anything. You know what I'm saying? So like I say, you can have fun, but when you start messing with shit that you're going to end up ending your career or ending you as a person, you got to think about it, man. Sometimes you be so much in having fun that you start to walk away from the shit that'll actually ruin you. And he ain't never been the same. And he done won championships. You know what I'm saying? Look at what happened to him. He won championships, man. He was on all-star teams. He was in a starting lineup for the Los Angeles Lakers that won championships, man. Come on, now. And one of the main reasons they won those championships. You know what I'm saying? So, like I say, man, the bad decisions can end up having you in some real fucked up in the places, man. You know what I mean? Like, man, it's sad to see bro like that, man. I hate to say it. It's sad to me, man, because I know how talented bro was. You know what I'm saying? Delonte West, I know how talented that man is, man. The same with Lamar Odom. The same with Steve Francis. You know what I'm saying? But, man, I'm going to see y'all next time, man. Appreciate y'all checking out the video, man. Being there, Charlie, man. new content coming. All right.